It is a beautiful summer's day in Melbourne, and Melbourne Park is where it's at the moment. Welcome back. You are watching Nine's Wide World of Sports. Now, I should say, and it is an old saying, sport and politics should never mix, and this is why. Sport and politics should never mix. And Sam, I suspect we might be adding to the show reel today, potentially.
No, I tell you what, I get the chance to get out on the court with our federal treasurer, Josh Frydenberg. Great to have you here as well, Josh.
But good to see you, Tom.
Quite a bit. And yeah, he's a lot better on the court than he is in some of the other politicians we saw just then. That's
well,
for sure.
you are a dab hand at tennis. I mean, in a past life, before you got into this other stuff you're doing at the moment, you're a champion tennis player.
I wouldn't go that far, Tony. I think my ambitions were far greater than my talents. But, you know, like many kids watching the program this morning, I had a great dream.
Look at that. One of the true tennis greats with Rod Laver.
Yeah, there's that big forehand by my own admission.
Come on.
Jeez.
Did you send these through yourself? Where did we get these?
Look, that's Photoshop, okay? There you go.
There's been plenty of that on this show this week, don't worry.
That's Tom Cruise's body, I think.
No, I don't want to ask it, but I have to ask it. What happened?
A few too many pies and a few too many scones and jam. But look, I have, you know, great ambitions to be a tennis player, but obviously didn't make it. But, you know, sport teaches you so many things about life.
Yeah.
About winning, about losing, teamwork, all that sort of stuff. So I have great memories.
Well, I know that you have a hit with Sam from time to time,
do.
And it gets pretty willing there. But when you said that you tried to downplay your background, you did win a title at Kooyong, didn't you?
Just the club championships, yeah. Which is pretty fought after, and they've had some big names, Tony, on the winners board there. They've had
us having a hit at Kooyong not too long ago.
There we are, and Paul McNamee and Neil Fraser and a lot of other really good players have won the club champs there, so it's an honour to join them on the honour board.
I spoke to Josh last night when I said I was playing Legends. The Legends, I'm playing in the Legends today, I don't know if you've heard, TJ.
Yeah.
I'm playing against Mark Philippoussis and Pat Rafter, and Josh did just happen to mention, you know, I have a pretty good record against both those guys as well.
I had a good doubles player, partner, in Josh Eagle.
Oh, yeah.
And we played Mark Philippoussis in the Williamstown Open, I think, final.
Yeah.
Took the honours there.
Really?
And against Pat Rafter, had a hit with him on the practice court at Ashley Cooper's Tennis Academy when he was coming through. Lost in a close tiebreaker.
Right, okay. But when you played the Scud, did the Scud have someone else with him, or was it just the Scud?
And he was only 12. No, he was older. He was older, and he was on the cusp of going great.
How does he go now?
No, really good. So the first time we had a hit, Josh actually, you know, connected us together, and I knew, obviously, that Josh had played a lot of tennis, and I went out with, you know, expectations, but once we got out there, I tell you, I had to turn it up a bit more than I thought I was going to have to. So
can't see his serve, though.
No.
Yeah, no. So Josh Eagle says you still can't see his serve, and so we're looking forward to you playing the Legends match.
Yeah. So was there a time where you seriously considered a full-time career in tennis?
Well, I took a year off, so I finished high school. I never wanted to finish high school, but my parents said, son, you finish high school, and we'll support you taking a year off. I did that, travelled around the world, Middle East, Switzerland, Europe, other parts of Australia, and tried my hand on what's called the satellite circuit, and didn't do that well. And then after that year, decided to go to university. And then while at university, I had some, you know, great tennis experiences representing Australia at two World University Games in England and the United States.
All right, well, let's see if you've still got it, because, Josh, I know you've got to get on a plane and get back to your other job, so you're going up to Brisbane today. So I'm going to put you to the test here.
Okay.
Now, I don't know whether you've had a chance to see this. This is what we call TJ's Pong.
Okay.
Okay, this is going to be a career highlight for you. So we're going to put a target on the board.
Right.
The outer ring is 1 point. The orange ring is 5, and then 10 for the middle.
Okay.
Okay. Now, I normally keep count, but mate, you're the treasurer, so you keep count. okay. Yeah. And but I will be making sure the figures are spot on. All right. So we're going to move that target. You've got 30 seconds on the clock, and well.
So just hitting a forehand, so, or something.
Yeah.
Like
however
so
you want to do
grab
it.
Grab a handful of balls.
Well, yeah. Just pretend you're in question time and give a few backhanders as well, okay, if you like. But okay. There you go. Quicker, Josh. Rapid fire.
You've got 30 seconds, mate.
Come on, rapid fire, Josh. Josh.
Oh, yeah.
Did you actually play tennis? Right, there you go. You're away. 5 points.
Oh, yeah.
Six points.
Come on, mate.
6 points. Let's speed the target up. 6 points.
Oh, this is good.
There we go. Boy, hello. You really sped it up now. What are you doing to him? 6 points. 3 seconds left on the clock. Oh, 7 points. Double figures at least, Josh. Okay, it's all right. Oh.
Very good game.
Oh, my goodness.
I prefer Space Invaders, okay?
Okay. Now, I don't know. Have we... look, there was someone actually playing things in the control room, but we won't go into that. I think they were trying to speed that up on purpose. We do have the leaderboard, though, so...
Oh, no.
Mate, all I can say is I hope the leaderboard on election night for you looks a whole lot better than that.
Okay, but, well, I'll be back here at 12 o'clock tonight practicing.
Okay, I'm sure you will. All right, did you have fun?
Thank you very much. Great to see you.
All right, and of course, you two will be on the court again at some stage.
We will.
Just warming up. So, Josh Frydenberg joining us there, former tennis great. Not so good with TJ's Pong. And
no one likes TJ's Pong, though, I'll tell you.
Oh, really, sir? Yeah. Good one, mate. Anyway, we're going to go to a break. And, of course, you know very well the sights and the sounds of this great country of ours. But as we go to the break, here's some more. This is with thanks to the Get Set Cam, just some of the beautiful scenery you can take in here at Melbourne Park. Please thank our Federal Treasurer, Josh Frydenberg.